We've talked before about intonating a four-string bass with a floating wooden bridge on it, but that might leave the question about, is it different to do it with a five or a six-string? That's what we're here to talk about today on Stonefield Music. Coming to you today with this beautiful five-string slimline model. It's got an Australian blackwood top, Solomon Island ebony fingerboard, and a gorgeous four-color burst on the back. But we're not here to talk about how good it looks today. We're here to talk about intonation with a five-string or a six-string instrument and how that might differ from the way we do it with a four-string. And now if you haven't seen the video on the fours, I would suggest you go back and check that one out just so you get a firmer understanding of what we're doing here in this video. So with the four-stringers, we intonated the E string, and we intonated the G string. And then we let the A and the D fall in. So we have perfect intonation on our highest and our lowest strings, and the A and the D string come so close that 98% of us can't hear the difference. We're going to do the same thing today with the five string instrument, in that we don't intonate the B and the G, we still intonate the E and the G. E and G perfectly intonated, A and D fall into position, and the low B you'll find also falls into position. So first thing we need to do, I'll loosen up the strings just so I can show, as I often do, that we can take the bridge right out. But it can be a pretty scary thing if your bridge falls out. But it's not a scary thing. We'll slide the bridge back in under the strings, saddle each of the strings, and using my index finger as a guide, I put it right in front of the lowest string carriage and I slide the bridge back into that position. That's generally a good starting point for the intonation process. Also, as a starting point for the intonation process, take the carriages for tuning and move them all into their most forward position. So that's anti-clockwise on the tuning knobs until the carriage moves and bumps its stop. That means bumps its stop. That means it doesn't crank on it until it crunches against the stop. Just enough. As soon as it hits the stop, you stop. All right, so with that, we'll get our tuner out. And the little drum tuning key that we use to bring strings to pitch using the headstock friction stays. With the system, we bring the string close to pitch at the headstock, and then we finish our tuning down at the tailpiece. Once the string has been brought to pitch in this manner, you usually won't use the headstock friction stays again until you change strings. All of your tuning gets done down at the tailpiece. So I'm going to ring a harmonic. And the goal is to get the harmonic and the fretted note at the 12th to ring exactly the same. Very close, finish with the tailpiece. Okay, we've got it. We've got an E harmonic. Now we'll lightly fret the E, and we're just a little bit sharp. So I'll loosen that off. And since we're sharp, that means the string needs to be longer. So move this just ever so slightly. You probably couldn't even see my hand move the bridge. Okay, we've got our E harmonic again. Let's check the E fretted. We've got it. The string is intonated. Let's move to the G. Ooh, got a long way to go on that one. Very close. Let's finish with the tailpiece. And there we are with G harmonic. Let's check G fretted. and just a little bit sharp. So again, we'll loosen this off. Now, do not let your E string position move, and since it's sharp, we need to move the G string position back a little bit. And let's try it again. We've got G harmonic. Slightly sharp. All right, we're going to loosen it up. Again, hold your E so it doesn't move. The slightest nudge backwards. We've got G harmonic. And we've got G. We're now intonated. So for the rest of the strings, we just bring them up to pitch. Done and dusted. If you want to learn more about the Tom Stanley tuning system, the floating bridge systems, and the other unique features that we have on Stonefield basses, please make sure to get over to our website, www.stonefieldmusic.com. Also check out our Facebook page, Stonefield Music, and our Instagram, Stonefield Music. We'll look forward to seeing you there, and I'll see you again here soon.